Good morning. Thank you for this opportunity. Hope does not disappoint. This African proverb best analogizes my source of inspiration and motivation. Right here in Kenya and across all 54 countries in Africa, youth like myself graduate into the labor market with nothing but hope for better days and years ahead. I have lived this story, and my breakthrough came with a change in perspective that was triggered by the hashtag Innovative Volunteerism. And the message was simple, that I could tap into Africa's $48 billion a year post-harvest losses and turn them into income opportunities by simply linking these areas to climate-based solutions. If we look at Kenya, we are losing up to $500 million a year as post-harvest losses. And if we look at maize, we are losing up to $200 million. I saw a gap. If I could ensure that this maize farmer gets access to quality organic inputs, then access to a quality solar dryer, get to dry his produce at his farm, increase the shelf life, then speculate for better market prices, a means to finance, and then linked to consumer markets, I would have tapped into this opportunity. And I realized that the job I was seeking lay in solving problems across the entire agro-value chain that 70% of our population is engaged in. Through UN Environment, EBAFOSA Innovative Volunteerism, I was linked to a software developer, Gideon, who is here with me today, and other clean energy actors, and the EBAgroPamoja application was developed and launched. As you can see, this is our web application, and we connect the dots across the entire agro-value chain. Through EBAgroPamoja application, clean energy enterprises are now being efficiently linked to consumer markets to provide solutions of clean energy like solar dryers, solar refrigerators, biogas, water harvesting. And now we are having clean energy SDG 7 incentivized and post-harvest losses cut to enhance food security SDG 2 and still, and better still, more money in more pockets if value is added using clean energy, which is cutting poverty SDG 1. The connections start at farm level, where the focus is linking actors to environmentally sustainable agro inputs like organic fertilizer, organic seeds, solar irrigation, and then they also extend to critical intervening areas of finance, logistics, and transport, where we make all these actors available within the EBAgroPamoja application. These connections also extend to markets, where we link the end product to lucrative markets. Of much interest to me is the training aspect incorporated within the EBAgroPamoja application, the training aspect where youth are given an opportunity to retool their skills and also to learn new skills from the entrepreneurs engaged across these agro-value chain intervening areas so that they can start their own enterprises. The core of EBAgroPamoja, decentralizing clean energy and environmentally sustainable inputs, is driving both climate mitigation and adaptation to drive SDG 13. Delivering all this is leveraging inclusive partnerships, which is driving SDG 17. And since we launched, we have engaged so many service providers across the entire agro-value chain, and we look to engage more. As EBAgroPamoja, we would also want to know how best do we build alliances to drive implementation of this innovation, given that the mindset buy-in is not always easy, how best to build loyalty between clients, suppliers, and other stakeholders to the business, and for those of us who have had success with their enterprises, how did you move your ideas from concept to full-blown enterprises that the market has bought into so that we can learn from that? And how can this summit take the EBAgroPamoja idea forward and blow it out to the world through promotion as well as enterprise collaborations? Thank you.